All of nature is connected, and our choices can affect more than we think.
I think that the marine biology course we are having at Sant'Anna Institute is a good way for students to learn about marine ecosystems, natural equilibriums of the ocean, and the knowledge on these topics, on biodiversity and richness of the ocean, is very important to be more respectful and more aware of human impacts. To quote a sentence that was released during an IUCN conference in 1968 by an African engineer, he said that in the end we will conserve only what we love, we will love only what we understand, and we will understand only what we are taught.
Everybody comes from a different environment. I was able to learn a lot about places where I've never been.
Throughout my marine biology class, I've learned that the Earth is full of diverse life that all have different conditions they need to survive in and contribute to their ecosystems. And if humans continue to harm the Earth at the rate they're going at without finding any solutions or alternatives, then we'll see an even bigger decline in the environment around us, and we'll be destroying even more life and the habitats they live in.
The idea of a marine conservation survey with students of the Introduction to Marine Biology came when we were thinking to the new course of marine biology with lab, and we thought that probably the best way to understand marine conservation is not only to visit institutions that are working and are making efforts in order to reduce human impacts, like marine protected areas and turtle rescue centers that we are visiting within the course, but also to try to understand the way people know about human impacts of nature. And instead of presenting information to students, it's much better to collect data and analyze this information together with them to make them more aware about it.
Through conducting the survey on awareness of human impacts on the environment, I learned that most people are aware there's a big problem, but they don't realize how much of a negative impact we actually have on it. And when asked what impacts humans have on the Earth, most people could only respond with certainty that climate change and pollution were problems. So I think there needs to be more awareness for other factors, such as habitat destruction and invasive species that also contribute to the downfall.
So for the Earth Day, I would suggest to people to start a path of deep understanding of nature through videos, through walks, through readings, documentaries, to enjoy this wonderful world that we have all around us.